The next generation has really struggled with figuring out where to start when it comes to the future of energy. And they want to make a difference in the world, but it just seems really complicated. They don't really feel like they have the access to the jobs that they need. What would you say, and what piece of advice would you give them as somebody who started out of college with GE Vernova and worked your way all the way to being CEO?
Benji, I appreciate the question. I mean, at the start, from my background, I grew up in upstate New York. I went to school in upstate New York. I wanted a company that I felt like was going to be a laboratory for me to experiment and learn, and GE represented that. It was a company that had a number of rotational programs that allowed me to travel to see different parts of the country and the world. It allowed me to do many different rotations professionally early in my career that allowed me to see a lot, and I think that context is critical early for a young person to figure out what they're passionate about, what they're interested in.
What piece of advice would you give to young people who want to make a mission-based impact on why GE Vernova is a great place to work?
So we are very tactical and strategic with where we put capital to bring people together and to give our young people opportunities that allow them to be able to triangulate different experiences into being big leaders early. And one of the things I often talk to my teams about is how fortunate I was with the opportunities I was given. I'll only run this company with confidence that someone coming through the ranks today, like I did 25 years ago, will get as much, if not more, opportunities as quickly as I did early in my career.
What do young people misunderstand about the future of energy and the energy space in general?
So sometimes I think young people think with the demand cycle we're going into, it's going to make it harder for their generation to ultimately yield the benefit of a decarbonized electric power system. The reality is the growth is actually going to be an enabler towards us making more progress faster.
Well, that demand creates the space for these technologies to thrive, because that demand for energy also demands these solutions to exist in the first place.
Exactly.
And that's what young people should be excited about. The future of energy can be really complicated, but it also can be very exciting. When you look ahead, what excites you most about this space?
One thing I do take a lot of confidence from is the fact when I do talk to young people, very often they do talk about climate change as an example as one of their generation's greatest challenges. I think the industry's opportunity is then to come to them. Mm-hmm. You know, we can't expect them to come to us. We have to go to them. And in going to them, we need their help. There's a lot of work to do. We talk about a decade of action and we mean it. There is work that must happen now. We can't plan on solving this problem in 2050. We need to make progress in 2025, while also positioning ourselves, and in this case, ourselves being the industry, the world, the planet, for the next 100 years. And there's a lot of solutions that we have in place that we can execute on right now, but with humility, there's a lot we still have to figure out. And we need that next generation to come into this industry to help us make that progress.
So to close, what would be your final piece of advice for the next generation?
I think it's a very delicate balance with finding the right level of humility and hunger. You always want to come into opportunities wanting to do part of your boss's job, right? But how do you do that with humility that allows you to keep growing professionally? The world needs leaders. Leaders don't come in any one shape and size. You don't become a leader based on your age, based on what you wear. It's how you approach problems every day.